to the announcements in your order of service and weekly email. Be sure to save the date for our UU Climate Justice Revival on Saturday, September 28th from 9 to 1 p.m. Note that you can sign up for that in the back of the sanctuary or email Sue Coleman, or she's right here in person. If you have a few questions, you can check with her. And join us next Sunday for Inviting Community with Reverend Sarah Smalley when we consider what it means to be Unitarian Universalist in 2024. Stay after that service for our Sign Up Sunday to find out ways you can get more involved in the UUFN. Again, welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Northfield.
Good morning, all. I am the Reverend Sarah Smalley, she, her pronouns, and I serve this congregation as its minister. As Mary Jane said, it is truly a delight to welcome Reverend Kristin back to the UUFN pulpit as our guest minister for the day, guest speaker for the day. Kristin is the minister emerita of this congregation and served as its minister from 2009 to 2021. She is a cherished and generous colleague to me, and I know beloved to many of you. Kristin, we are so glad you are here today. So let us begin our sacred hour together. Our opening words are from Reverend Lisa Friedman. We touch the floor to remember that wherever we bring our best self is holy ground. We reach for the sky to remember that we are a part of a mystery much bigger than ourselves. We hold hands to remember that we need one another and are a part of one human family. We join voices to remember that we each have a gift to offer the world and to use in making the world a better place. Come, let us worship together.
The The flaming chalice is the symbol of Unitarian Universalism, illuminating the path of justice, hope, and love. Each Sunday, when we gather, we bring this symbol of life together. Let us say the words for the lighting of our chalice. Let us open our eyes to see what is beautiful. Let us open our minds to learn what is true. Let us open our hearts to love one another.
Good morning. I'm Kristin Maier. I use she, her pronouns, and I have to say it is such a delight to be here. It really is, to see so many faces that I know and love, and new folks too, which is just thrilling, and to see the many ways that this congregation is thriving. We really are, and it's just wonderful to be here. The story I'm going to tell today is the Sun Goddess of the Heavens, and it's one I've told a few times here before. Hopefully it's an oldie but goodie. It is certainly old. It's from the Kojiki, which is the oldest book of Japan, a collection of stories about the gods and goddesses of Japan. And this story is about Amaterasu Omikami, the sun goddess of Japan. And we're going to tell this story, and I say we because I need your help. Will you help me tell a story?
Yes.
Oh, good. That's right. You're ready. I'm going to have you do a couple of things in the story. One is to play the role of some roosters. Now, roosters in Japan do not say cock-a-doodle-doo. They say koko-koko-ro, or at least that's the phrase for what roosters say in Japan. And I'm going to give you the signal in the story, like this, flapping my wings, because I'm so dignified. I'm going to flap my wings, and then we'll all say koko-koko-ro together. So let's practice that once. Very good. Make excellent roosters. And then the other thing I'm going to have you do is pretend like we're having a great party with laughing and singing and dancing. And in the story, I will give you the signal, and I'll give us a little beat, a bum 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 bum, a bum bum, and you can clap and you can sing along with me and laugh and just make a big noise, happy time. So let's practice this once. Hit it. Bum 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 bum. Oh, perfect. We are ready. The Sun Goddess of the Heavens. Long, long ago, high in the heavens above Japan was the land of the gods and goddesses. It was a peaceful land ruled by Amaterasu Omikami, the sun goddess. The sun goddess was a kind and gentle ruler. When she smiled her gentle smile, all of the heavens were at peace. Well, Amaterasu had a little brother named Susano no Makoto who lived down on earth. And one day, Susano called up to his sister, "Please, sister, can I come up to the land of the heavens and live with the gods and goddesses?" And Amaterasu responded, "If you are to live in the land of the heavens, you must promise to behave and not make any mischief." Susano called, "Yes, sister, I promise to behave and not make any mischief." And Amaterasu smiled her gentle smile, and Susano climbed up into the land of the heavens. Now, Susano was the little brother of the sun goddess, but he was also a strong and powerful god who liked to play rough and rowdy sometimes. And at first, he remembered his promise to his sister, but after a while, he forgot. And soon he was stomping through the land, wrecking the canals and the fields that the other gods and goddesses had built. But Amaterasu did not worry. "My little brother is just making some mischief," she said. "I'm sure he won't cause any more trouble." And she smiled her gentle smile and said nothing. But Susano got rowdier and rowdier as she smiled her gentle smile. And one day, Amaterasu had called all of the goddesses into the loom house where they were weaving a cloth of gold that the gods and goddesses would wear. And while they were working, Susano crept up to the loom house. He took a huge horse's hide and tossed it through the window. It landed on the loom, and the loom shattered. Pieces flew everywhere. Some of the goddesses were injured. Amaterasu was furious. She could no longer smile her gentle smile. She ran to a nearby cave, hid herself inside, and sealed the door shut with a boulder. Without the sun goddess, the heavens and the earth were plunged into darkness. While all the gods and goddesses rushed to the cave, they called out, "Sun goddess, please come out and smile your gentle smile. The world has been plunged into darkness." But no sound came from the cave. The strongest gods and goddesses tried to move the boulder. They pushed it and they pulled it and they pushed and pulled together, but they could not make it budge. They would need another plan. First, they built a giant bonfire so they could see. And I understand you know about nice bonfires here at UUFN. Then they gathered all the roosters of the land and brought it near the cave. And finally, they brought a large 8-sided mirror and positioned it perfectly in front of the entrance of the cave. Now they were ready. They began to dance and sing and laugh. Hit it! Deep inside the cave, Amaterasu heard the sound of music and laughter. How can there be music and laughter when the world has been plunged into darkness, she wondered. What is going on out there, she called. It's the new sun goddess, they responded. We are welcoming her. New sun goddess. Curious, she opened the boulder just a crack. Light shot out of the cave. Thinking it was dawn, the roosters began to crow. How can it be dawn without me? She wondered. She opened the boulder a little bit more to peek out. And there was the mirror. Not recognizing her own reflection, she saw the light of another sun goddess. Beautiful, she said, and she stepped out of the cave. Quickly, the gods and goddesses managed to shut the boulder behind her. Everyone clapped and cheered, for the world was filled with light again. Oh, sun goddess, they said, please do not plunge us into darkness ever again. And the sun goddess, seeing how much all the gods and goddesses needed her, forgot her anger, and she smiled her gentle smile once again. And Susano no Mikoto, he was sent back down to Earth for a little while to think about what he had done. The end. Please rise in body or spirit for hymn number 118, This Little Light of Mine.
Each week during worship, we slow down out of the busyness of our lives and invite our hearts to catch up with us. And so with these words of hope and joy and story and light still echoing in our hearts, let us slow into this space and arrive fully in this moment. Let us find our breath. Let our breath find us. Each week we share the sorrows and celebrations of our own lives. In the presence of a love that holds us all, we light our first candle as a blessing for the wider world. We light this candle in solidarity with Haitian immigrants who this week have faced racist scorn and racist tropes and threats of violence after hateful and undeniably racist lies put forth by political candidates. May this be a light of truth and compassion. We know too that the details of our daily lives are sacred and important. We now light a candle for all of the simple joys that are sustaining us.